Welcome back to the Talking Hedge. I'm Josh Kincaid, capital markets analyst and host of your cannabis business podcast. Today, we've got Lofa Tatupu, retired NFL linebacker, all pro with Seattle Seahawks, some other teams we don't care about, just the Seahawks. Now he's in charge of ZoneIn CBD. Welcome to the podcast, Lofa.
Man, thank you for having me, brother.
So I think the XFL, I don't think is drug testing, the MLB, and hockey, they don't really test.
They all test that they screen, but they don't penalize. If his threshold is over the nanogram per milliliter limit that they set for the league, then they'll do the right thing. They'll get him counseling and see if there's a problem, which I don't believe there is, you know, but it's just at least they're looking out for them that way. But the MLB just reversed course and they said they're no longer going to penalize for it. Hockey definitely. I think hockey and football are the ones that need it most. I was excited to see the XFL go into the game this Saturday, the Dragons. So excited to see their home opener. I'm hoping the NFL follows suit. You know, it's the right thing to do by the players and by the game. I they're going to make the game better. Why wouldn't you want to make the game better?
Or safer. How can cannabis help with chronic traumatic encephalopathy or CTE? The National Football League or NFL made headlines when they showed that their interest in studying the potential use of cannabis as a pain management treatment for its players. The announcement was made after the players' labor union, the NFL Players Association, had already made its own independent study of cannabis-related search. And so the new interest in cannabis as a sports medicine comes on the heels of former players demanding that the NFL revises cannabis policy. In their retirement, these former NFL players have turned to cannabis to address their long-lasting pain directly associated with injuries sustaining by playing a collision sport at a professional level. So has it helped? I don't know if you have CTE or you know anybody who does, but do you know if and how cannabis can help with CTE?
I don't think there's enough, you know, that's a dangerous subject to broach in terms of, you know, saying, oh yeah, it'll fix. Yes, CBD and the other phytocannabinoids are neuroprotectants. That's known, but can it regrow or repair neurons that were lost or damaged? I don't know. I feel good, like I said, cognitively, yes, but you know, you don't, at least the last I heard, my dad, who it'll be 10 years in 2 weeks that he passed away. Mm-hmm. He was diagnosed with CTE and early onset of Parkinson's. Now, I didn't think he seemed that bad, but again, I don't know what he was dealing with internally, right? So I do know that, you know, that he was going through the same cognitive deficits that I was in terms of, you know, we talked about, hey, you know, how's your memory? How's your mood? The things that, you know, just, you know, kind of get associated with, you know, brain injury. I can't, it's too touchy of a subject for me to say, oh, you know, yes, it'll fix that. I've seen people come out and say that. And I think that's reckless, you know, because there are guys that are on prescribed meds that maybe we don't agree with that, but if they're helping, they're keeping him from, you know, self-harm or harming others, then, you know, you can't ask him to just get off that completely and, oh yeah, just take the CBD. That's what I worry mostly about when I speak about this. If someone, you know, hears that they can just go to the extreme and just stop taking their prescribed meds. You know, we are not doctors, and, you know, the research is still not there where we can say it definitively.
So with that, we're going to roll this one up. I want to thank my guest, Lofa Tatupu. He's CEO of ZoneIn CBD. Thanks for being on the podcast.
All right, brother. You take care. Have a great day.
I'm Josh Kincaid. This is The Talking Hedge. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Or don't. And I'm out.